morning students. In this video you are going to learn about the percentage composition, Avogadro law and application of Avogadro law, then the relationship between relative molecular mass and vapor density. So the first topic, percentage composition. So far we were dealing with the number of entities present in a given substance, but many times the information regarding the percentage of a particular element present in a compound is required. For example, ointments and syrup. So in this label they list out the percentage composition of ingredients. So the percentage composition is very important, or they needed. So the percentage composition of a compound represent the mass of each element present in 100 gram of the compound. Each element present in 100 gram of the compound. So let us understand the percentage composition of oxygen and hydrogen by taking water. For example, water, H2O. So it can be calculated using the formula. So percentage composition formula. So mass of an element is equal to mass of that element in the compound divided by molar mass of the compound. This percentage means multiplied by 100. So in the water they contain two elements, one is hydrogen, another one is oxygen. So we have to find out the mass of hydrogen as well as mass of oxygen. So before that, first we have to calculate the molar mass of the compound, molar mass of the water. So what is the formula? H2O. So molar mass of the water is molar mass of water, H2O, is equal to, they contain two hydrogen and one oxygen. So hydrogen mass is 1, so totally 2 hydrogen present, so 2 into 1, 1 oxygen present, so oxygen mass is 16, so 1 into 16, 16, so 16 plus 2, 18 gram, 18 gram is the molar mass of the compound. Now we want to calculate the mass percentage of hydrogen. Okay, so hydrogen only 2, so mass of hydrogen is 2. 2 hydrogen, each hydrogen have 1, so totally 2 hydrogen. So 2 divided by molar mass of the compound is 18 multiplied by 100. So 2 into 100, 200 divided by 18, so cancel out, we will get 11.11%. So mass percentage of hydrogen in water is 11.11%. Similarly, mass of oxygen, mass percentage of oxygen. So oxygen, only 1 oxygen present, so 16. So molar mass of the compound is 18, so 16 divided by 18 into 100. So 16 into 100, 1600 divided by 18, they cancel out by 88.89%. So mass percentage of oxygen is 88.89%. So this percentage composition is useful to determine empirical formula and molecular formula. This percentage composition is used to identify or determine the empirical formula and molecular formula. So for example, find the mass percentage composition of methane. Methane is a hydrocarbon. So what is the formula? CH4. So one carbon, four hydrogen it contain. So first the molar mass of methane is, for one carbon mass is 12, for four hydrogen, one hydrogen having mass 1, so four hydrogen means 4 into 1 is equal to 4, so 12 plus 4 is 16 gram. So molar mass of methane is 16 gram. So first you want to find out the molar mass of carbon. So mass percentage of carbon. First you want to find out mass percentage of carbon. So carbon only 1%. So 12 divided by molar mass is 16. So 12 divided by 16 into 100. So 12 into 100, 1200 divided by 16, they cancel out by 75. So 75%. So mass percentage of carbon is 75%. Then mass percentage of hydrogen. So what is the mass percentage of hydrogen present in methane? 4. So molar mass is 16. So 4 divided by 16 into 100. So 4 into 100, 400 divided by 16. So cancel out by 25. So the mass percentage of hydrogen is 25%. So in methane, carbon can present 75%, hydrogen present 25%. Then the next topic is Avogadro hypothesis. Avogadro law is very very important. 2 mark question. Avogadro law. In 1811, Avogadro framed a hypothesis based on the relationship between number of molecules present in equal volume of gases in different condition. So what is the law? The equal volume of all gases, equal volume of all gases under the similar condition of temperature and pressure, equal volume of all gases under similar condition of temperature and pressure contain equal number of molecule, contain equal number of molecule. So equal volume of all gases under the similar condition of temperature and pressure contain equal number of molecule. It follows that the volume of any given gas must be proportional to number of molecules in it. The volume is, V is the volume. So V is the volume, N is the number of mole. N is the number of moles of molecules of a gas. The Avogadro law is represented directly proportional, both are volume and the number of moles are directly proportional. So V directly proportional to N. That is the law. When the volume increases, number of moles increases. When the volume decreases, number of moles also decreases. Okay. So volume is directly proportional to N. N means number of moles. V means volume. So here proportionality constant. So V is equal to, instead of proportionality constant, we have to write the constant. V is equal to constant into N. Thus the 1 liter of hydrogen contains the same number of molecules in 1 liter of oxygen. The 1 liter of hydrogen contains the same number of molecules as in 1 liter of oxygen. That is, the volume of gas is directly proportional to the number of molecules. So that is a law. So volume of gas is directly proportional to number of molecules. That's why V is directly proportional to N. So explanation. Let us consider the reaction between the hydrogen and the chlorine to form hydrogen chloride. So H2 plus Cl2 gives 2HCl. Hydrogen is a diatomic and chlorine also a diatomic. Both react to give 2 molecules of HCl, 2 moles of HCl. Here, 1 volume of, before that, 0 means it contains 1. Here also before the Cl is 0, so 1. So 1 volume H2 and 1 volume Cl2, both are combined to form 2 volume of HCl. So according to the Avogadro law, 1 volume of any gas is occupied by N number of molecules. So 1 volume of any gas is occupied by N number of molecules. N molecules plus N molecules. So N plus N, 2N. So 2N molecules is formed. If N is 1, so 1 plus 1, 2 molecules. Half plus half, one molecule. So one molecule of hydrogen chloride is made up of half molecule of hydrogen and half molecule of chlorine. So molecules can be subdivided. This law is in agreement with Dalton atomic theory. This is agreement with the Dalton atomic theory. So next important question is application of Avogadro law. So both Avogadro law and application of Avogadro law, they are asking in detailed question. So application of Avogadro law, they have 5 points. The first point is, it explains Gay-Lussac's law. So Gay-Lussac's law is used to explain only gaseous molecule. Okay, so Avogadro law is used to explain Gay-Lussac's law. Second point, it helps to determine atomicity of gases. It helps to determine atomicity of gases. So already we know that atomicity, number of atoms present in molecule. So especially in gases, they determine the atomicity. Avogadro law is used to identify or determine the atomicity of the gases. Then the third point, the molecular formula of the gases can be derived by Avogadro law. So we want to find out the molecular formula of gases by using Avogadro law. So molecular formula of the gases can be derived by using Avogadro law. Then the fourth point, it determines the relationship between molecular mass and vapor density. It determines the relationship between molecular mass and vapor density. Then the fifth point, it helps to determine the gram molar volume of all gases. Avogadro law helps to determine gram molar volume of all the gases. Already we know that 1 molar volume is equal to 22.4 liter at the standard temperature and pressure. Once again, I repeat all those points. First point, it used to explain Gay-Lussac's law. Second point, it helps in the determining of atomicity of the gases. Third point, molecular formula of the gases can be derived by using Avogadro laws. Fourth point, it determines the relationship between molecular mass and vapor density. Then the last point, it helps to determine the gram molar volume of all gases, that is 22.4 liter at standard temperature and pressure. Then the last topic in this lesson is relationship between vapor density and relative molecular mass. So this is the important detailed question. Relationship between vapor density and relative molecular mass is also a very important detailed question, 7 more question in this lesson. So you have to learn thoroughly. So they have 2 points. First point, relative molecular mass, then vapor density. So first we should know about the definition of relative molecular mass and vapor density. So what is the definition? The relative molecular mass of the gas or vapor, relative molecular mass of a gas or vapor is the ratio between mass of one molecule of the gas or vapor to mass of one atom of hydrogen. It is based on hydrogen scale. Okay. So what is relative molecular mass? Ratio between mass of one molecule of gas or vapor to mass of one atom of hydrogen. Then definition of vapor density. What is vapor density? Is a ratio of mass of certain volume of gas or vapor to mass of an equal volume of hydrogen measured under same condition of temperature and pressure. What is vapor density? The ratio between the mass of, for example, certain means one volume of gas or vapor to mass of one volume of hydrogen. The ratio between mass of one volume of gas or vapor to mass of one volume of hydrogen. That is the definition of vapor density. So vapor density Vd is equal to, see, we have to write in the formula type. So definition, is write in the formula form. So vapor density is Vd is equal to, you have to write the same thing. So mass of given volume of gas or vapor at STP is divided by mass of same volume of hydrogen. So you have to change this. Given or same, you have to write 1. So mass of one volume of gas or vapor at a standard temperature and pressure divided by mass of the one volume of hydrogen. So that is called vapor density. So according to the Avogadro law, so what is Avogadro law? Equal volume of all gases is contain equal number of molecules. Equal volume of all gases contain equal number of molecules at standard temperature and pressure. So let us, the number of molecules in one volume is equal to n. So you have to change one molecule, change it into n. So you have to change 1 into n. So Vd is equal to mass of 1, you have to change n. So mass of n molecule of gas or vapor at STP divided by mass of n molecule of hydrogen. Then cancelling n, which is common, so you get Vd is equal to mass of one molecule of gas or vapor at STP divided by mass of one molecule of hydrogen. Okay, then cancelling in this formula, you have to change that mass of one molecule of gas or vapor at STP divided by mass of one molecule of hydrogen. Already we know that hydrogen is a diatomic. Hydrogen is a diatomic. Okay. So in this formula you have to change that. One molecule is changed into two atom of hydrogen, because hydrogen is a diatomic. So you have to write that Vd is equal to mass of one molecule of gas or vapor at STP divided by mass of two atom of hydrogen. Okay. So this formula is easily converted into in this formula, because you have to change one molecule into two atom of. Okay. So Vd is equal to mass of one molecule of gas or vapor at STP divided by mass of two atom of hydrogen. Then when you compare the formula of vapor density with the relative molecular mass, they can be represented by Vd is equal to mass of one molecule of gas or vapor at STP divided by 2 into mass of one atom of hydrogen. Okay, hydrogen is a diatomic. So 2 hydrogen is chemically combined. Okay, so 2 into mass of one atom of hydrogen. So 2 into 1. 2. Okay, so 2 into mass of 1 atom of hydrogen. So that's why we have to multiply it with the 2. So 2 into mass of 1 atom of hydrogen. So they converted into molecule. Then the relative molecular mass based on hydrogen scale. So mass of 1 molecule of gas or vapor at STP divided by mass of 1 atom of hydrogen. Okay, so already this formula we know that it is called RAM, relative molecular mass. So relative molecular mass, already we know that mass of one molecule of gas or vapor at STP divided by mass of one atom of hydrogen. So instead of this ratio, we have to write relative molecular mass. Okay, relative molecular mass. So already we know that here, already we know that this equation divided by 2. So instead of this equation, we have to use RMM. So RMM divided by 2. You have to change that. So relative molecular mass divided by 2. Okay. So Vd is equal to relative molecular mass divided by 2. So 2 is cross multiplied with Vd. They converted into 2 into Vd, vapor density is equal to relative molecular mass. So that is the final formula. 2 into vapor density is equal to relative molecular mass. our relative molecular mass is equal to 2 into vapor density. That is the final answer. So this relationship is very, very important, students. You have to learn thoroughly. So that's all about the atoms and molecules lesson. Thank you, students.